Hey, what's going on guys, this is Ali and today I'm going to show you how can you create a bootstrap dynamic slider in ASP.NET MVC and SQL Server. And this is the demo project that we are going to develop in this tutorial. You can add new images from this view and that images will be displayed here, right? So I will choose one more file, upload it. Now refresh the page here and that image should be displayed here. Right? So open up Visual Studio and create a new project. Give it a meaningful name. Select MVC and press OK. Now open the home view, go to Solution Explorer and under the views folder, within the home folder, open index view. We need to write the code for the bootstrap slider. To save our time, I will just copy and paste it right here. Remove this bunch of code and go to the W3 school. In carousel section, copy this code from here . Create a div here container. And we'll add some padding from top 3 pixels. Within this div, paste that code. Okay, we will have 5 images, so copy this line 2 times. Okay, and this will 4. Now I will add some images. First create a folder. Copy these images and paste it within this folder. These images are just for the demo purpose. We will delete these images later. Save the changes and run the project. Okay, now I will create a database. Open SQL Server, and create a new database. Slider demo DB. Now I will create a new table. One column will be ID, the data type will be int, and add a primary key. And this will be auto incremented. Okay, and the second column will be image path, and the data type will be varchar max. Okay, save the table. Okay. Right. Now go back to the Visual Studio and add a data model. Click on data, entity data model, click on EF designer from database, click next, new connection. Select database, test connection, press OK. Now we will create an action method in home controller. Create an action method. This will be HTTP GET. Copy this, paste it here, and this will be the POST. Now we will add a view. I will select create template. Press add. Okay. In this action method, we will save image path into database and images will be saved in images folder, which is right here. Okay. First, we will get the image name. path.io. So git file name without extension, pass dto.image file that image. Now we will get the extension. Copy this from here and paste it here. Okay. We will send a success message to the view. Viewback.message. Save the changes and run the project. Navigate to the add image view / home add image. We need to make some changes in this view, so go to the view and first remove this from here and add here, change this to add image. Now I need to specify the controller and action method. This is the action method and the controller name is home. Method is post. Let's remove these two lines. We need to add an HTML file upload control. input type will be file, name will be image file, this will be required, and the Bootstrap class will be form control. Okay, and this is the create button. We will change the value to upload. After this, I want to display a success message. View bag dot message. Save the changes and refresh the page. Let's try to upload an image. I will select number 1. Press upload. Uploaded successfully. Now let's check into database. This is the image path. Let's check into images folder in our project. That image is also successfully saved in our images folder. I will remove these three images from here because I will generate Bootstrap carousel slider from database. So delete this. Okay, now go back to the Visual Studio and stop the project. First we will get images from database. Okay, so now I will modify the index view. Go to index view. Okay. Remove this piece of code from here. We will use for each loop to get data. Item in model. And here in image source, image path. Save the changes and run the project. So guys, we have only one image. Okay, we need to upload more images. So go to the add image view. From here we will upload more images. Okay, refresh the page. We have a very serious problem with our carousel slider. To resolve this issue, switch to the Visual Studio. This little trick will resolve that issue. Okay, save the changes and refresh the page and see the result. Okay, and this will be completely responsive. Right. That's it for today guys, I hope you have learned something new from this tutorial. Don't forget to subscribe my channel. Thanks for watching.